Now let's look at the concept of function here. A program takes input, process, and serves the output. So instead of looking at the kitchen now, we'll be looking at C++ program. Now, just now we were inside the kitchen. Now we are inside the program. So let's say this is your programming space. This is where you write your code. Yeah, you add preprocessor to add all the necessary library functions. Ah, they are library functions, built-in functions that are already there for you to use, right? So sometimes when you do mathematical expressions, you call the mat.h, right? To make use of functions like POW, square root, log, yeah? All these are built-in functions that has been written by programmers that produces the compiler. So the code, you have the main function. Inside the body, there are many lines, there are many statements until it reaches return. Yeah? How long can it be? It depends on the problem you need to solve. Now, what happens is that imagine there's a pipe here. This pipe is called input stream. Input stream is a pipe that's connected to the keyboard or any other input. But for this example, I use keyboard. Then there's another one called output stream. Which is connected to the display. Yeah? Now, this input string is called STDI. And, no, the other one is in C. It's called CIN. This one is called CR. So whatever you dump to CR goes to the display. Whatever that you dump into C goes into the program. It goes into the program. The program is stored at the is executed by the processor in the memory. But coming in, you need to store in memory. It comes into the program, but you don't store in memory, you cannot reserve the value. It will just disappear. So that's why you need to put it inside the memory. Now, how do you get a memory?
Declare
variable. When you store a value inside a variable, you're storing it in the memory. Always put in memory, then only process. Can I not? So, input, you dump into the memory by making variables, you process the variables using algorithm, using mathematical expression. And then, if you need to display, sometimes you don't want to display, right? You need to display, then you dump it into the, you dump it to C out. So that's what we have learned so far. Now, this is only one function. Let's say this function is very, very long, and you notice that this group of code and this group of code are similar. These three lines and these three lines are similar. Then, why not we take these two out and create a new function? Let's call it function one and place the code here. After all, they're similar. Right? So, if I have transferred the code, the similar code, into a single function, I can remove the long code, the long line, the long statements. I simply replace with the function name. Correct or not? Please pay attention, this is the key part of it. This is function call. You're calling the function. This is function call. Yeah, listen carefully, yeah? This is function call. Who calls who? Main function calls function one. Now, where's function definition? What does F1 do? What does function one do? That's called function definition. What does F1 do? Function definition. So function definition, what you need to do is you find this function and you look at the body. What's inside the body? This is what we call function definition. Because it defines what F1 does. Definition of F1 is given by what it does the inside. This will be your algorithm, your mathematical expression, whatever. Yeah? Now, from the main function, you're just calling this function. So, calling this function, you do not need the body, right? You just need to call the name of that function, that's it. Just one line. I need function one. I need function one again here. I need another function one. Doesn't this sound like a manager? Or in the analogy just now, the kitchen's main chef? Yeah, the chief? Yeah? But before you can call the function, you need to define the function. Unless the function is a library function, very popular function like POW, POW function. Like this one is three square, right?
Yeah.
Yeah? Now, but even then also, you must tell this program that I'm using POW function from
CMAT.
From CMAT. I'm using POW function from CMAT. Even then also, you need to tell this code. I'm using this. But this one you don't have to define. You don't have to define what POW is. You can put there float POW and then what's inside, no need. Because it's already built in. It's provided by CMAT. But for functions that are not built in, you write the function. Right? Some functions you write, some functions you use from the library. So what's library here? It contains not books, but it contains functions. They are very, very popular. So what do you do before you write your own function? Check whether this function already exists. Definitely, the built-in function is probably better than yours. I'm not saying that you cannot write a better function, but most likely it's better. So reuse that function. For functions that you cannot find, you write. So the purpose of function is reusability. Now, it's very important, okay, to know the purpose of function, reusability, to know what is function call, and to know what is function definition. Before you can call the function, you should define the function. Yeah? That's why in the code, you must define the function before you use it. Now, remember or not in coding, how does the compiler read your code? Top down, right? Line by line. Before you can use that function, you need to define. So where do you define the function? You define the function before you use it. Analogy. Before you take a stranger out for a meal, somebody has to introduce that stranger to you, right? You will simply, come, let's go for meal. No, you won't do that. No. But there are examples where you see that the function definition is after the main function. Correct or not? Now, in that case, you can do that, but you must declare before the main function. You still need to declare. Main function, we have the definition of this function beneath you. So that's called function declaration. Another thing you need to know, function declaration. So, it must be before main function, and to tell the main function that Hey, actually, we have this function defined already. It's just after you. So make sure you know function declaration, function definition, and function call. Which one do you use if you want to use the function? Declaration, call, or definition? Call. Which one you use to clarify the scope of that function? Function, definition. Yeah? Which one you want to make sure that the main won't be scared of this particular function? Function declaration. So it becomes no more stranger to the main function. Yeah? Do you know now why main function is called main?
Yes.
Because it's a function that calls other function. Which function you execute first? Main function or other functions? If you have many functions, which one you execute first?
Main
function. The first line in main. From there, it will call other functions. Now, have you ever thought why there's a return statement at the end of main function? Every function ends with a return statement. Every function ends with a return statement. Why this return? Now, let me help you to make sense of it. Now, let's say from the main function, I call function 1. Now, function 1, semicolon. Straight away, semicolon only. Because after that, it will jump to the definition. When it jumps to the definition, of course, it starts with the first line of the other function, right? Execute, execute, execute. At the end, it gets what? Return. Return to where? Return to where it is calling from. So it returns. Return. Return the result. Let's say return result. Data type is integer. Return to where? To where it calls from. To where it's being called from. So if F1 is called from here, the result will be returned just after F1 call. Now if F1 is called here, first line, second line, third line, fourth line, fifth line, so the return will be returned to the line 6, just before line 6. Let's say this is line 5, line 6. So it's calling function 1 at line 5. So it goes to this line, execute, 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 return result. It'll be returned to where? It'll be returned to just before line 6. Then we continue until it reaches return. Return of the main. Now, the main returns to who? These other functions return to main, right? These other function 1, function 2, accessory functions. I call them accessory. Because main is here, others are accessory. This accessory function will return to main. Main return to who? Main return to the operating system. Main return to the operating system. If you're using Windows, main will return to Windows. If you're using Linux or Unix, it will return to Linux or Unix. And it's telling operating system, I'm done. You can kick me out from here. Main function return to the operating system, telling the operating system that I'm done. You can kick me out from the memory. All right?